Hello everyone, this is meteorologist Dave Snyder at the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Anchorage. I wanted to share with you a webpage that we like to share with a lot of our customers, and hopefully you'll find it useful as well. This is a way to display the forecasts that our meteorologists here in the office have come up with using their training and the meteorological models that show us the possibilities of weather over any particular area. When you go to preview.weather.gov/graphical, this is the page that you'll see. We've got a couple things we can do here. We can change our view with this drop down. We can change the field of information that we're looking at, and there's a lot to choose from. And you can change the time using the slider here. There's also some other pre-assigned views that you can choose from the national view to the CONUS view, Alaska view, which we'll use here in a moment, Hawaii, Guam, Puerto Rico, the tropical Atlantic, and the tropical Pacific, and lots of other options here that you can adjust to suit your needs and then save. We're going to jump to Alaska, so just click on Alaska here, and that will take you to our Alaska view. And once again, we're starting off with the maximum temperature here. You'll see it takes a moment or two to load. You also have your time period and the temperature scale seen there. The temperatures that you'll see will be the most recent for that time period, or the latest what we call package, or the group of forecast information pieces that are issued together. Usually that happens in the morning and the afternoon. In this case, you can see the maximum temperature for Thursday afternoon. That'll be tomorrow at this point. We can scale through that, and you'll see it takes a moment again to load, but it brings up the next set of values there for Friday, for Saturday, or whatever day you see in the next 6 to 7 day range. How about we look at snow? Let's go back to our Alaska view here and click on Southern Alaska Coast. That's going to include the northern Gulf Coast of Alaska, the Kenai Peninsula, Prince William Sound, and parts of the Anchorage area and Matanuska-Susitna Valleys. As that's loading up here, we should also drop this down to snow amount. What that will display is the values for snow, and we can run that ahead with our slider here. So let's crank that back to Wednesday night. That'll give us the most recent 6 to 12 hour period there. And you can see the color shading across parts of the Wrangell-St. Elias Range into the very eastern parts of Prince William Sound around Cordova, Alaska, and into Whittier, which is more on the western side. You use the arrow buttons here and just slide through, and you'll notice the values and the contours changing with time as we go ahead. The time is printed out right here. It's saying ending February 13th. Going into Valentine's Day, early in the morning, still some snow falling. Well, that gives you a view of what's happening during a very specific time period, but what if you want to see snow totals during that time period? Well, let's take our drop-down menu here and go to Total New Snow. And so what you'll do is page this forward once again, and you can see those numbers building over time during that 48-hour period. So starting on Wednesday and going all the way through the end of the week and into Friday, I'll let this load up here for just a moment, and you can see those values increasing. So places like Yakutat during this time period may accumulate as much as 25.2 inches of snow, a considerable amount of snow there. And we also have snow falling around Prince William Sound, places like Seward, and even Anchorage there, although our forecast amount is not very high at this point. So this is a pretty interesting tool. Once again, you can set this up to look at many different variables, anything from maximum and minimum temperature, probability of precipitation, will it rain or snow or sleet or freezing rain in your area. That is the value or grid that you could look at to demonstrate that or show that where you are. Well, let's say you're only interested in the Anchorage area. You can do that easily by zooming in, dragging your map around, and you'll see the contours and the sizes of the features on the map adjust and change to what you're selecting here. Pretty easy stuff to use. You have a number of map options you can toggle on and off. If you don't like the map, try the satellite map, or perhaps you like to see Google Roads. You can do that too. You can change the opacity of the forecast grid area, the point values there. You can add in other boundaries like counties, coastal zones, and the county warning areas from each National Weather Service office. You can change the units if you'd like to look at all of this in metric. So a lot of things are possible, and again, you have many other views to choose from if you're traveling or if you just like to examine this on your own. So again, the webpage is preview.weather.gov, and once you get to a site or a specific view that you like, go up here, grab your bookmark, and just drag it onto the desktop, or perhaps save it in your bookmark area. For the National Weather Service office in Anchorage, I'm meteorologist Dave Snyder.